Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. It's been a minute, but today I'm coming back at you guys with another Boss Babe video. I was going through all the requests because I have put up so many Boss Babe videos within the past like probably 2 years, covering everything, as you guys know, from organization to credit repair, budgeting, finance, law of attraction, how to make a living on social media. I think a lot of my new followers actually found me as well from a video I did last year called How to Make $20,000 on YouTube specifically. If you found me through that video, leave a comment below because I'm always wondering like what funnels and ways people are directed to my channel, so it really helps me out. But the majority of questions I always get from you guys in my email and in my Instagram DM and everything is specifically how can you make money on social media, or if you're already making maybe a part-time living or it's like your side hustle, how can you turn it into your full-time job? And you guys already know this is my main passion, helping other young female entrepreneurs to turn their passion into a full-time job, being able to make more revenue so that you have the freedom to stay home with your kids and just do something that you absolutely love. Ultimately, I think there is nothing better than working for yourself, setting your own hours, creating a program or your Instagram or your YouTube around your topic of expertise and something that you just wake up and you're so joyful to talk about and to teach. And you guys already know, social media and YouTube has really changed my life. So it's now my mission to share with you exactly how I've created the current state of life and my reality that I have and exactly how I make revenue. This video is not clickbait in any way. I am gonna be showing you today exactly how I make money on social media. All the affiliate programs I'm a part of, how I sell my programs, my ebooks, making revenue on YouTube. I will go in depth and fully give you guys the exact strategies that I use to make revenue. I've been doing YouTube now, I think for like over 4 years, but the first two, I wasn't really making any money at all. Obviously, it takes a lot of consistency. You have to build up your audience, etc. But the past 2 years, I'm really blessed to say it has been my full-time income, which is, again, just so amazing that I can be home doing something I love and be here for Christian. Since you guys know I have him full time, that has been such a blessing for me, not having to put him in a daycare or anything. Obviously now he's in school. And yeah, actually in December of 2018, I had my highest revenue grossing month to date, which was a little over 30 grand. Keep in mind, your girl ain't ballin', like I can't keep all of that money. I do have 3 employees now and then I have to save for taxes, which is another thing we'll talk about in this video. A lot of you ask the money that you make through sponsorships and through YouTube. How do you save that? How do you get taxed on that? And most times you don't. Companies will actually send you a 1099 form and you'll be put down in their system as an independent contractor, meaning they will tax you at the end of the year. So you need to be diligent on yourself and save about 25% of that income yourself. Cause you're going all the way back to Uncle Sam, okay? But yeah, despite having to pay out my employees and save for taxes and all that, it was the biggest month in business that I've had, which I'm so grateful for. And I feel like I've found what really works for me in my business and what ways to approach companies I work with, YouTube, selling my own programs, and with everything combined, I've been able to make it just this incredible living, which I want for all of you. So be sure you subscribe and you are part of the Boss Babe Squad. I would so appreciate it, you guys. We're so close to 500K, like I can't believe it. It also looks so weird in the viewfinder. I know we're in a totally different new setup today. I'm completely redoing my office, as you guys know. So for today, hopefully you're okay with the kitchen background. So first way that I make money, as you guys know, is here on YouTube. It completely just depends for the month how many video views you get. I wanna clear up a few things here. A lot of people think when you thumbs up a video, the creator is paid for that. Not true. You're only paid on YouTube if you have monetized your account in your Google AdSense settings. I will leave a link down below. If you're a YouTuber and you haven't monetized your channel yet, I know YouTube recently did change the rules last year because so many people are YouTubers now, and they did have to like crack down on it. I believe you have to have 4,000 hours of watch time and you have to reach at least 1,000 subscribers before you are able to monetize your channel. But I'll put a link down below where you can apply for monetization. You have to make sure that your channel is monetized and that you are running ads on your videos. That's the reason you guys may see certain channels have like a billion ads in one video. That's because whether they're basic ads or premium ads, that content creator is getting paid for that video. Personally, I think audience retention is very, very important. You don't wanna lose subscribers. So if you've been watching me a while, you'll see I maybe put like 2 or 3 ads in the middle of a video if it's like a longer vlog, but I will never bombard the video with like 10 or 15 ads in the middle. That's just ridiculous and it takes away from the consumer experience of watching the video, in my opinion. So everyone's CPM rate on YouTube is actually different. Some people have premium ads that may be a perk of signing with a management company or a network, but I have my own views on that. I recently got out of my contract with Studio 71, and it looks like my channel still has premium ads even without being with them, so I don't really think a network is necessary. They did not do much for me within the past 2 years. I literally negotiated all my own sponsorships, all my own deals. That's a whole nother rant. But yeah, I am finally a solo creator again. I did not renew my contract with them and I am doing totally fine. I'm actually making more than I was with them because when I was with them, they were taking a percentage of my AdSense revenue. And now I still negotiate all my own sponsorships and run my channel myself. But they're just not taking any of my pay when they literally weren't doing anything for me. So anywho, a huge portion of my monthly income, yes, is YouTube due to sponsorships and due to Google AdSense revenue. So again, I have my channel monetized. And again, I know everyone is always wanting to know exactly how many views per month equals how much revenue. I don't mind being upfront. I'll share my exact analytics with you guys from last month. So pause really quick and give this video a like if you appreciate just, I don't know, the transparency. I know no one really likes to talk about money, but I don't know, I don't mind. So if you guys would give this video a like, it really just helps me so much to share the video. But anywho, last month I got right under $5,000 for my total monthly Google AdSense payment. So $5,000 worth of revenue. Again, they will send you a 1099 at the end of the year. That is counted as independent contractor income. So just make sure you save tax money from that. But last month I had 700,000 overall YouTube video views combined for the month. It does reset every single month. Your AdSense pay depends on total overall monthly views with all your videos combined. Even the videos I put up 5-6 years ago. Well, on my channel, I've only had my channel for like 4.5 years or something, but people always ask, can you still make revenue off of older videos? And yes, as long as they're monetized and you have an ad running at the beginning or the end and your channel's been approved for monetization, you don't only get paid for the videos you put out that month, like your new videos, you get paid on the combined video views on your channel every single month. So that's a little equation for you if you wanna make $5,000 every month. I had last month 700,000 total video views. And I talked about in my other video, I've had AdSense months where I've made 12, 13 grand, where I had like 1 or 2 million views a month when some of my videos have blown up. My AdSense definitely spikes up and down depending if I get a viral video or like what my average is at the moment. But that's a pretty good standard like average CPM rate. Like specifically for you guys to follow if you're trying to make $5,000 a month, if you're trying to make $10,000 a month, literally just double those video views and you'll kind of have your goal set and know like what you need to work towards. So another big way that I make money every single month is through sponsorships. Now, I don't like to do too many, again, kind of with the whole throwing in a ton of ads in your video. You always want to keep your consumer like watch time and retention high, and you obviously want to keep the loyalty with your audience so they will purchase and they will trust your opinion on the products you talk about. I am so, so, so secure in the sponsorships that I do. I know they're incredible companies. I feel amazing recommending you guys their stuff because they have good customer service and I'm promoting a product that I really love. You guys would be blown away at the amount of emails that I turn down, the amount, hundreds of sponsorship like inquiries that I get that I do not talk about. I probably do like 2 or 3 sponsorships every month. Companies that I have worked with in the past that I continue to work with that I really love are ThredUp, Poshmark, Fabletics, Thrive Market. I do work with First Form, but they don't pay me like an upfront fee per video. I only get paid like when you guys purchase the products, I get like a small commission per product that is sold. That's another way to make revenue through social media. If you team up with a brand and you constantly talk about their products, anytime you guys see one of your favorite affiliates or YouTubers having a coupon code, they are making a profit once their customer or their follower uses that code. It's usually a pretty small commission between like 5% and like 12%, so like a few bucks per sale, but if you have a huge following, it really does add up. I know for me, I feel like I have a very dedicated audience and you guys are amazing when I talk about something and you use my code. That does contribute to my overall revenue and I'm so thankful that you trust my opinion on things. And again, I know people wanna know the exact amount people make per sponsorship, so you know I'm here to give it to you real. It totally just depends if you have a really engaged audience and you have a super high ROI, because that's the only reason a company wants to hire an influencer ultimately is to get sales. They want to get their product or their business out there and they want to drive sales. So they're always going to give you a coupon code or a link and they're going to track those sales and see how many people, how many of your followers clicked on that link and actually came through and made a purchase. So it really benefits you if you have an audience that's very loyal and they trust your opinion and they use those links. That's how you're able to make stable revenue every single month by keeping that connection and that trust with your audience, which is why I find that it's super important for me on my channel to stay like super connected with you guys, even at the subscriber rate that I'm almost at. Like, I still respond to probably almost every comment, which is getting a little out of hand. It takes me so long. Some of you think I have an assistant doing that. I don't. I have her doing other things such as email and payments and stuff for my courses, but whenever I respond back to you on YouTube or like an Instagram DM, you can have full faith knowing that it's me. I think having that personal connection with you guys is really important. But yeah, for the sponsorship rate, if you have a good engaged audience, I usually find that a good average is for every 100,000 subscribers, you can ask for $1,000 per sponsorship. So I'm almost at 500,000 subscribers, but my video views do go like this. Some do a lot better than others. It totally depends. So I do not ask for a full $5,000 per sponsorship. That would be pretty high. For me currently, it ranges between like 2,800 to 4 grand-ish, but it totally depends. And I have to come through with the sales that the company is expecting on that video if I wanna work with them again, or if I wanna get paid, or if I wanna like hit a higher commission tier. So again, it all goes back to having that loyalty and that trust with your fan base and you really being able to sell a product and having them click the link, use your code, etc. So we have affiliate marketing, we have Google AdSense Pay, we have sponsorships. Then the most important thing, which took me almost 3 years, why am I out of breath? Okay, let's take a break. Took me almost 3 years to realize is you need to create your own brand. You need to create your own products. For so long, I was just doing YouTube, which obviously I still do, and it's super fun, and it's been such an incredible blessing in my life. But I've also realized there's so many things through YouTube, like I said, making a full-time living on social media, to where I wanna share that knowledge back with other people. So I decided to come out with my own ebooks on how to grow and engage organic community on Instagram. So I have my Instagram ebook, which is 15 bucks. And then I also have my first ebook about creating your dream life and manifesting the higher quality of life that you deserve. So I have two separate ebooks, so every month I will get revenue from those. A lot of you wanna know how to make an ebook, how to host it on a website. So I actually use Canva to make my ebooks. It's totally free. Canva is amazing. They should totally be charging people a monthly subscription because it's incredible. You can make Instagram graphics on there, podcast graphics, ebook stuff, and then you basically download the ebook or the file or the worksheet that you've created to your computer, and then you can go sell that on your website. So for my website, I do use bigcartel.com. I will link all of this down below because I know it's so much info. Some of my family uses Shopify. If you're selling a physical product like a t-shirt or merch, you could use Shopify or Amazon. You could do like drop shipping. But for me, I'm just selling electronic products like PDFs, like my ebooks. So I do use bigcartel.com. That costs me about 10 bucks a month. It's a business expense. It's a write-off. And then as soon as someone purchases my ebook, we email it to you right away. So I do also pay every month for a service called Pulley. I believe it costs me about 10 to 12 bucks a month as well, which is 100% necessary in my business. And if you have an online business, I highly recommend you get it. Again, it's a business write-off. Pulley actually connects with Big Cartel. Whenever someone purchases one of my eBooks, Pulley emails it to that customer right away. So I do not have to go into my email and manually send you guys my eBooks or my worksheets or the media kit that you're buying, because first of all, if you have a big audience and say you do a sale or something and you have 100 people order, there's no way you can keep track of every single email and send everyone the file individually. It takes way too much time. So for 12 bucks a month, Pulley sends you guys the file the minute you buy it from my website. It's a lifesaver. I've been using it for like 2 years. So yeah, a lot of you also asked how to create your own website. What website host would I recommend to you? I'm gonna link Wix down below along with Big Cartel. Those are the only two that I've had experience with these past few years. So, and that leads me into my fifth revenue stream, which is my social media courses, which now have actually ended. I offered an Instagram course and a YouTube course through a website called Kajabi, which tons of my friends use, tons of my social media friends who are business coaches or fitness coaches. Kajabi is an incredible platform where you can upload video tutorials and video trainings and worksheets and create a course to sell to your audience regarding your topic of expertise. So I had a YouTube course and I had an Instagram course. If you're one of my current students, don't worry, you can still view the course for a lifetime. You have lifetime access to all the worksheets, the ebooks, and to go in there and keep viewing the videos at your own convenience. But I've actually stopped selling those two courses just as of yesterday, actually. I had about 330 something total students, which is so cool. And I'm so blessed to say that many of you trusted me to be your mentor and invested in me. And I have had so many awesome testimonials. But as we know, my true passion and what I really believe is my calling is to help women realize that they deserve to attract a better quality of life. Everything regarding wealth and money and abundance manifestation, you guys know, is that's my shit. Like, that is what I love teaching women on. So I'm currently creating my 8-week wealth and abundance course. So that's the only reason I'm not currently still selling my other two social media courses, just because I wanna put all of my time and energy and focus and 100% passion into my new course. But yeah, that's a huge part of my revenue is Kajabi. Now, it does cost you, if you're a business owner or you wanna sign up for Kajabi, it costs you between $99 and $199, I believe, every month to host on Kajabi. Now, again, in my opinion, completely worth it, completely a necessary business expense, because if you didn't pay for that or you didn't have it, you wouldn't really have a platform to run your courses on. So Kajabi has been very beneficial for me. There's landing pages to sell your product, and then you have an entire video portal where your clients can log in and view the videos and view the course material that they've purchased from you. There's also a comment section, so you can comment back and forth with your clients if they need any help on any of the modules or they're struggling. Again, I like to keep that personal connection open with you guys and like with my business clients as well. So Kajabi has been excellent for me, and overall, just really starting my own brand and LLC this past year, aside from YouTube, has really taken my revenue to the next level, because I'm able to have the YouTube income, the sponsorships, but then on the side, have my eBooks and my own brand and my own vision and passion in creating my own products, which is really something of my own, right? Like, that is my major takeaway from this video. Have something of your own. YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all of those platforms are owned by other people. We cannot control the algorithm. We cannot control if they decide to charge for those services one day. We could wake up tomorrow and Instagram would be like, okay, we're charging every user $10 a month, which would be such a smart business move on their part, because there's something crazy like 80 billion Instagram users, active Instagram users every single day. So imagine if they charge like a monthly membership fee or something, they'd literally be so much richer than they already are. Like, that would be insane. But what I mean is, you cannot control those other apps because you don't own them. So make sure that you're establishing yourself as your own brand, setting up an S Corp or an LLC, and making your own revenue through your own brand, through something that you can control. That also goes for having your own mailing list, another thing that took me way too long to start. If I would have started sooner, I would actually have so many more subscribers than I currently have, but having something like MailChimp or Kajabi and having your own mailing list is something that you own. Again, if your Instagram or YouTube were to get hacked and you had like no business or no revenue, you're like, what am I gonna do? At least you would have your email list with people's first and last name and their email information, so you could still send them information about your products or a flash sale. Having a mailing list is also incredible if you're gonna host a meetup. You guys know I'm gonna be doing a live event, which I'm so excited for. We already started looking into Airbnbs and getting the event catered, talking to some of my other friends on social media and having them come to speak at the event. And MailChimp is excellent for that as well. You can let people know about anything, any type of sale you're gonna have on your program, a new course launch, a meetup, an event, etc. Incredible. Again, in my opinion, a necessary business expense. All right, so I think that will pretty much do it for my personal income streams via social media. I'm gonna link every single resource down below for you guys for your success. Please check it out, you guys. Check out how to build your own website, how to create your own ebook. Think about really establishing your own brand. You can actually go to LegalZoom.com if you want to create an S Corp or create an LLC and really establish yourself as a real legit business. Highly recommend that. Also, what was one other thing? Oh, I wanted to let you guys know some sponsorship sites. If you are a YouTuber and you're looking to partner with brands, I have no problem like sharing my resources with you guys. Grapevine.com and FameBit.com are awesome sites that actually connect the creator to the brand. You can see if you're a good fit, and then you can talk about their product on your channel and actually get paid for that. So yeah, check out everything down below, guys. I really hope this video was helpful and informational. I hope you appreciate me just being transparent about my own pay, specifically with the intent of helping you guys to succeed. So again, I really, really appreciate if you can give the video a like. Again, that's another thing. Us creators are not paid on the likes per video, but it really helps YouTube to possibly put this video in like the recommended section or shoot this video to someone new who may want to, you know, be a subscriber and join the Boss Babe Squad. So it really does mean a lot to me. I appreciate it, guys. If you want to sign up for my newsletter, it's totally free and you will get all the information for my LA meetup and my live event. So I'll have the link down below. Just pop in your email and I will send you the details for that. You guys can't tell, but I'm sweating under here. Okay, I'm excited later because I'm getting a furniture delivery for the tea lights I wanted in my office, and we're fully redoing my office to be like this calm, serene, like meditative, like, I don't know, like good energy space that I'm like fully redecorating for my videos. So hopefully in the next video that will be completely done and you guys can see like the full update. And ooh, I'm so excited. I have like such a vision for it. So thank you for watching. I appreciate you guys. Also follow me on Instagram if you would like. Be sure to subscribe here to my channel and I will see you guys in the next video.